Well, hello, everybody. And my name is Casey Jones Costello, and this is Gail Hyde. And I hope that some of you have seen us before, wherever you are watching this program that we've recorded for you today. And we have a program of a lot of what I call wistful songs, a lot of songs of romance and love, as well as nostalgia and memory. And some of those themes are intertwined and indelibly linked with one another. And so while we usually do a traditional Valentine's Day program with love songs each year, this is a love song program with some songs that may not be associated with Valentine's Day, but I think nevertheless fit well with a love songs theme and the theme of nostalgia and memory, which I think this year in particular, 2021, as we are now almost a year into the COVID-19 pandemic, I felt was sort of an appropriate theme for this year. Songs that that bring back memories and are filled and tinged with nostalgia and wistfulness and love. So all of those themes are represented in our songs today, and I hope that you'll enjoy them. Our first song is a piece from 1927 with music by Horatio Nichols and words by Edgar Leslie. It was popular in the 20s, but also was revived in the 1950s and made popular again by the Italian-American singer Connie Francis. And the song is called Among My Souvenirs.
Once told me a story. I built my castles on air. Life soon was dimmed of its glory. I loved, but you ceased to care. Nothing left for me of days that used to be. I live in memory among my souvenirs. Some letters tied with blue, a photograph or two. I see a rose from you among my souvenirs. Treasure chest, and though they do their best to give me consolation, I count them all apart, and as the teardrops start, I find a broken heart among my say you were not fair. Yet just because I loved blindly, I have the burden to bear. There's nothing left for me of days that used to be. I live in memory among my souvenirs. Some letters tied with blue, a photograph or two. I see a rose from you among my souvenirs. A few more tokens rest upstart, I find a broken heart among my souvenirs.
Judy Garland also covered that song on her 1957 album Alone. And if you've not heard her version of it, I recommend looking it up on YouTube or anywhere else, because her version is just very so beautiful, in my opinion. This next song we're going to do is a piece. We're going to jump 33 years ahead of the last song we did. And this piece was from 1960s off-Broadway musical, the longest off-Broadway musical in the history of musical theater in the United States, called The Fantastics. And I actually starred in a version, a high school version of The Fantastics when I was, oh gosh, it was the summer after ninth grade. And although I had the lead part in the show, Matt, I think is his name. Ironically, the lead male role doesn't get to sing the best song on the show, or at least what I think is the best song on the show. And so I've tried to rectify that in the years since by including it as often as I can in my programs. And I think it fits particularly well with this program because it's not only about love, but it's about nostalgia and wistfulness, and I hope you enjoy it. So with music by Harvey Schmidt and words by Tom Jones, not to be confused with the "What's New, Pussycat?" Whoa, whoa, whoa. Not that Tom Jones. A different Tom Jones, but of the similar vintage, 1960s. And the song from The Fantastics is called Try to Remember. September, when life was slow and oh so mellow, try to remember the kind of September when grass was green and grain was yellow. Try to remember the kind of September when you were a tender and callow fellow. Try to remember, and if you remember, then follow. Try to remember when life was so tender that no one wept except the willow. Try to remember when life was so tender that dreams were kept beside your pillow. Try to remember when life was so tender that love was an ember about to billow. Try to remember, and if you remember, then follow. Is hollow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember the fire of September that made us mellow. Thank you. And Jerry Orbach, later of Law & Order fame, originally sang that song in the original off-Broadway production of The Fantastics. And Ed Ames of the Ames Brothers, and later a singer, a soloist, and a wonderful baritone, had a popular recording of that song as well. This next song we're going to do is another piece, actually, coincidentally, from 1960. I didn't intend for that to be the case. I just realized it just now, actually. But indeed, both songs were written for 1960 stage productions, the main difference being that The Fantastics was an off-Broadway production, and this next song was written for a Broadway production. 1960's Camelot, written by Lerner and Lowe, as they were known, or as they were known fully, Alan J. Lerner, the lyricist, and Frederick Lowe, the composer. And they wrote a lot of shows together. The popular 1956 show My Fair Lady, as well as 1947's Brigadoon, 1951's Paint Your Wagon, 1959's Gigi, which originally was a movie, and then 1960's Camelot. And Camelot's always been one of my favorite shows because I'm a big fan of Richard Harris, and Richard Harris starred in the film musical version of Camelot. And the only thing that would have made the movie better, in my opinion, is had they cast Julie Andrews as Guinevere, because Julie Andrews originally starred in the Broadway production as Guinevere, and Robert Goulet starred as Lancelot. And so neither Andrews nor Goulet reprised their roles for the film, but I did love Richard Harris in the role, and I love Julie Andrews, and I love Robert Goulet, so I love the movie soundtrack, and I love the original Broadway soundtrack equally. And Julie Andrews actually introduced this next piece in Camelot, and she said was said to have been quoted as saying that she actually only learned this piece the night before the curtain opened for the premiere of Camelot, because they kept making revisions to the score up until the very last minute. And so, being the consummate professional that she was, she learned this the very day of the show and sang it impeccably, as she always did. And I still love Julie Andrews to this day. She's one of my greatest inspirations. So from Camelot, this song is called Before I Gaze at You Again. This next piece we're going to do is, in my opinion, certainly one of the most beautiful and most plaintive songs ever to come out of the Broadway musical theater canon. And the music was written by the great maestro Leonard Bernstein, with lyrics by Stephen Sondheim before he got into writing music for his own lyrics and shows. And, of course, their collaboration together was 1957's West Side Story. And had COVID, excuse me, had COVID-19 not happened, Steven Spielberg was set to release a remake of the movie version of West Side Story this past December. But because of, you know, theaters being mostly shut down, they bumped the release date to next December. So I look forward to seeing that, although, to be honest, I can't imagine it being better than the version with Natalie Wood, because I love Natalie Wood. But anyway, regardless, it's a beautiful score, and this is one of my favorite songs from the score, and it's called Somewhere.
There's a place for us, somewhere a place for us, peace and quiet and open air wait for us somewhere. There's a time for us, someday a time for us, time together with time to spare, time to learn, time to care, someday, somewhere.
This next song we're going to do is a beautiful piece written by James, with music and lyrics by James Horner, Barry Mann, and Cynthia Weil. And James Horner, some of you may know if you're movie composer aficionados, as one of the great film composers of the last, you know, 40 years. And unfortunately, he passed away a few years ago in a plane crash. But he wrote some beautiful scores during his career, including the scores to one of my favorite movies, Titanic, in 1997. And he wrote this beautiful song in 1986 for the film An American Tale, which was actually an animated feature about a mouse. And it was produced, it was either produced or directed by Steven Spielberg. So it had a lot of critical acclaim, and with good reason. So this song from 1986 is called Somewhere. Oh, and also it was performed originally by Linda Ronstadt as a duet with James Ingram. And the song is called Somewhere Out There. Thank you.
Someone's thinking of me and loving me tonight. Star, and when the night wind starts to sing a lonesome lullaby, it helps to think we're sleeping underneath the same big sky. Somewhere out there, if love can see us through, sleeping underneath the same big sky. Somewhere out there, if love can see us through, then we'll be together somewhere out there, out where
this next song we're going to do is a piece from the 1945 British operetta called Perchance to Dream, with words and music by Ivor Novello. And most of you probably are not familiar with Ivor Novello unless you are fans of early 20th century British music, or if you happen to be British yourselves. But he was a contemporary of Noel Coward and wrote in a similar style and wrote operettas, words and music for his operettas. And he remains very widely known in England and the UK. And there's even a songwriting competition named after him and for his legacy. His most popular song in America is probably his 1914 World War I hit called Keep the Home Fires Burning. But we're not doing that today. We've done it before, but it doesn't quite fit with the theme of today, I don't think. But this next song certainly does. And even though it's British, I think it always has a particular resonance with Rochester because we are the lilac capital of the world. And even though the Lilac Festival was canceled last year and who knows what's going to happen with it this year, this next song is wistful and it sort of speaks to that hope that eventually loved ones will be together again. And things will be happy and normal again. And it's called We'll Gather Lilacs.
Mm-hmm. have a scheme, a dream to try. I'm thinking, dear, of you, and all I meant to do when we're together, you and I. We'll soon forget our care and pain, such lovely things to share again. We'll gather lilacs in the spring again, and walk together down an English lane, until our hearts have learned to sing again. Come home once more, and in the evening by the firelight's glow, you'll hold me close and never let me go. Your eyes will tell me all I want. The simple joys we knew and shared together night and day. We'll watch without a sigh the moments speeding by when life is free and hearts are gay. My dream is here for you to share, and in my heart my dream becomes a prayer. We'll gather lilacs in the spring again, and walk together down an English lane. When you come home once more, and in the evening by the firelight's glow, you'll hold me close and never let me go. Your eyes will tell me all I want.
Well, this next piece we're going to do is a love song of sorts, but it's more of a love song that speaks of a love of one's homeland, and in this case, that would be the Shenandoah Valley, and it's an old American folk song which dates back to the colonial days of America, and it was thought of as a sea shanty. Its exact origins are unknown, but regardless, it's an American song and one of the most beloved of all American folk songs, and I certainly think it constitutes as a love song, and it has certainly both nostalgic and a wistful character to it. So I hope that you'll enjoy our performance of this next piece, arranged by Jay Althaus, and the song is called Shenandoah.
Oh, Shenandoah, I long to to hear you away, you rolling river. Oh, Shenandoah, I long to hear you away. I'm bound away, cross the wide Missouri. Tis 7 long years since last I saw you.
Well, this next piece we're going to do is sort of in the same vein as the last piece. It has the feel, certainly, of a traditional American folk song, which is not the case. It is not an American folk song, but it was what its composer was going for when he wrote it. It was composed, actually, by the Czechoslovakian Bohemian composer, Antonin Dvorak, Anton Dvorak, and he wrote it as the Largo movement from his symphony From the New World, Opus 95, and I believe it premiered in 1893, but don't quote me on that. And anyway, so the whole purpose of the symphony was to evoke the New World, that being America. And so there's a lot of, so-called American themes in it, or songs, or piece, rather, musical movements that evoke traditional American themes. And William Arms Fisher, who was a musician who studied under Dvorak, wrote words and a musical adaptation of the Largo movement from the New World Symphony, and added words to it and titled it Going Home. And he said it had the characteristic of a black or a Negro spiritual, and as such, it's been covered over the years by many classical singers, art song singers, including people like Paul Robeson and many of the greats of the 20th century. And so it's a beautiful song. It's not a love song per se, but again, it just has such a beautiful, wistful quality and plaintive quality to it that speaks of, you know, this love for this love of one's childhood home and the memories associated with that. That I think it fits into our program today. And I hope that you'll agree and enjoy the piece. And it's called Going Home. Thank you.
some still day. I'm just going home. It's not far, just close by, through an open door. Work all done, care laid by, gwine to fear no more. Mother's there, expecting me, father's waiting too. Lots of folk gathered there, all the friends I knew.
Well, this next song we are going to do is one of the more interesting songs, I think, in the program. It was written back in 1902 by two female composers, which was unusual for the day because the vast majority of songs were written by all male composers, with the exception of a few people who managed to have popular songs at the turn of the century in a male-dominated field. And this song was written with music by the composer Amy Woodford Findon, with words by Lawrence Hope, which was actually a pseudonym. And it's a song that is one of several songs that evoke the spirit of India. And it's I believe the song cycle from which this song came was called like Four Indian Love Songs, or Love Lyrics. And indeed, the music certainly evokes that Middle Eastern Indian feel to it. And its lyrics are just equally as stirring as the melody. And it was covered by many artists, many classical artists and classical crossover artists from in the first half of the 20th century. And even to this day, to some extent, but less so than in the early days of the 20th century when it was popular on radio by many classical singers and crossover singers, including Nelson Eddy and Jan Peirce, Richard Tauber, and even Rudolph Valentino, the famous silent movie star, recorded this song. It was one of only two recordings that he made during his very short lifetime. So it's a beautiful and sort of a haunting song, I think, called Kashmiri Song. Well, this next song we're going to do is another piece from the earlier set decades of the 20th century, written back in 1926 for the operetta The Desert Song, which was a very popular operetta with music by Sigmund Romberg and words by Otto Harbach and Oscar Hammerstein II. And in my opinion, Romberg is one of the most underrated composers of the 20th century. He was widely acclaimed through the 1950s, but then he's largely been forgotten since that time, which I think is quite unfair to his legacy because he wrote so many beautiful pieces. And, of course, anything, in my opinion, that Oscar Hammerstein II contributed to is good because he's just one of the best lyricists that there ever was. And Otto Harbach was quite good, too. And The Desert Song was one of the most successful operettas of the 1920s. And this is a piece about love that the narrator, the singer of this song, is thinking about if he only had that one woman who loved him, then his life would really be complete. The thing missing in his heart would be complete. So it's a more lighthearted song about longing for love. And a lot of artists covered it over the years, including one of my favorite singers, the great Mario Lanza, who would have celebrated his 100th birthday on January 31st of this year, because he was born January 31st, 1921. And so I think it's fitting that we should do this song, and it's called One Alone.
Lonely as a desert breeze, I may wander where I please, yet I keep on longing just to rest a while, where a sweetheart's tender eyes takes the place of sand and skies, all the world forgotten in one woman's smile. One alone to be my own, I alone to know her caresses, one to be eternally the one my worshipping soul possesses. At her call, I'd give my all my life and all my love enduring. This would be a magic world to me if she were mine and all my love enduring. This would be a magic world to me if she were mine alone.
Well, this next song we're going to do is a piece written back in 1924 by a German composer by the name of Dr. Robert Katscher, K-A-T-S-C-H-E-R, so I'm not sure if that's being pronounced right, but Dr. Robert Katscher. And it was very popular in 1924, so much that an American version was written in 1926 with lyrics by B.G. Buddy De Silva, and who was a famous lyricist of the 20s and 30s. And this song in its American version with the title When Day Is Done was performed by a number of artists, including the great King of Jazz, Paul Whiteman, and from everyone from jazz bands like Paul Whiteman to tenors like Mario Lanza, and even the Lawrence Welk Show's Joe Feeney have covered this over the years. And I think it's a nice song for our program. It's definitely a love song, but also a song of that paints a picture of memory and nighttime, and I hope you'll enjoy it. So from 1926, When Day Is Done.
Since you've gone away, one thing is clear to me. You were dearer than dear to me from the moment you came. Evenings by your side, I learned to love the night, but the loveliness of the night is no longer the same. When day is done and shadows fall, I dream of you. When day is done, I think of all the joys we knew, that yearning returning to hold you in my arms. Won't go, love, I know, love, without you night has lost its charms. When day is done and grass is wet with twilight's dew, my lonely heart is sinking with the sun. Although I miss your tender kiss the whole day through, I miss you most of all when day is done. Vesper bells are ringing somewhere far away. There's a silvery star away at the edge of the sky. Work is done and life is like a song to me, for some treasures belong to me that no money can buy.
Next song we're going to do is a piece written back in 1950 for the MGM musical called Royal Wedding, and it featured the great Fred Astaire as well as Jane Powell. And Jane Powell is one of my favorite singers, and she's one of the few stars from the golden age of Hollywood still alive today, as of January 2021, and she is She's 91 now, and she still, at least the last time I saw a picture of her, still looks just the same she did in the 1940s. And she's always been one of my favorite musical stars. And she had just such a beautiful lyrical soprano voice and a charming on-screen persona. And she sang the song, she introduced it in the film Royal Wedding, with music by Burton Lane and lyrics by Alan J. Lerner. And Burton Lane's probably best known for his musical Finian's Rainbow, which premiered in 1947, as well as his other musical, On a Clear Day You Can See Forever, which he also co-wrote with Alan J. Lerner after he collaborated with him on Royal Wedding. And they worked on a number of projects together, actually. And this is one of their best songs, in my opinion, that they wrote together. So from Royal Wedding, it's called Too Late Now. This next song we're going to do is, I believe, the most recent piece in our program, probably by quite a few years. I think the most, it's probably the second most recent one is about 18 years older than this one. And this was written back in 1999 for the film Walt Disney's Toy Story 2, which was a Disney Pixar Animation Studios collaboration. And if you haven't seen it, it's a great movie. Really, all of the Toy Story movies are really fantastic movies. Even if you're not a fan of animation, you know, they really have great stories to them and a lot of heart and sentiment. And one of the great things about the films, the second one is actually my personal favorite, and that's the one from which this next song comes. One of the great things about the films is the music, which was written by Randy Newman. He wrote the score as well as some of the original songs which were featured in the movies, including You've Got a Friend in Me, which some of you may know, as well as this next one. And it was nominated for an Academy Award for Best Original Song, and for good reason. Sarah McLachlan introduced it in the film. And if you haven't seen the song, heard the song in its context, you might be inclined to think that the song's about romantic love or the loss of romantic love or a lost relationship. But in fact, the lyrics speak to the relationship between a toy and its owner. It's sung by I don't remember her name, but it's the cowgirl. There's Woody and then Woody's friend, who's a cowgirl. And when Woody meets the cowgirl, they're both toys. She talks to Woody about how she once had an owner who loved her and treated her like the most important thing in the world until she one day grew up. And so it's similar, in my opinion, to the Peter, Paul, and Mary song, Puff the Magic Dragon, which was similar, had a very similar theme, and is another one of my longtime favorite songs ever since I was a kid. But we're not gonna do Puff the Magic Dragon as well, because I don't want to include too many tearjerkers. So I hope you'll enjoy this next piece from Toy Story 2, When She Loved Me.
When she loved me.
This next song we are going to do is one of the oldest songs in the program, which is ironic given that the title of this next piece is actually I Cannot Sing the Old Song. So I guess if I manage to make it through this song, then that's not quite accurate. I can, in fact, sing old songs, and in fact, that's usually what I do. But nevertheless, the title of this next piece is I Cannot Sing the Old Songs, and I guess at the time it was written, which was 1868 or thereabouts, there were songs even older than that on which to reminisce and look back upon and recall fondly, and that's sort of the theme of this song. Thinking back to old memories, halcyon days of yore, and bygone friends and memories, and the songs that evoke those memories. And that's one of the reasons I love this song, because for me, as someone who loves music and loves to sing, a lot of songs bring back memories for me, and sometimes it can be difficult to sing certain songs that have certain associations, and I just I love the sentiment of that and of this piece. It was written by a composer named Clarabel, which was actually a pseudonym for Elizabeth Barnard, who was an English composer and poet. She wrote the music and lyrics for all of her songs, and she was quite popular in the mid-Victorian era, but sadly she passed away when she was only in her 30s, and so I believe she died only about a year after composing this song in 1869, but this is one of her most famous pieces, along with songs like Come Back to Erin, which were covered well into the 20th century. So whether you know this song or you're hearing it for the first time, I hope you'll enjoy it along with its sentiment. It's called I Cannot Sing the Old Songs.
I cannot sing the old songs I sung long years ago. Heart and voice would fail me, and foolish tears would flow. For bygone hours come o'er my heart with each familiar strain. I cannot sing the old songs or dream those dreams again. I cannot sing the old or dream those dreams again. I cannot sing the old songs, their charm is sad and deep. Their melodies would waken old sorrows from their sleep. And though all unforgotten still, and sadly sweet they be, cannot sing the old songs, they are too dear to me. I cannot sing the old songs, they are too dear to me. Sing the old songs, for visions come again of golden dreams departed and years of weary pain. Perhaps when earthly fetters shall have set my spirit free, my voice may know the old songs for all eternity. My voice may know the old songs for all eternity.
This next piece we're going to do is actually the oldest piece in the program. So I Cannot Sing the Old Songs is the second oldest piece, but this one was written back in, actually I don't have the exact year here, but was written sometime in the lifetime of Robert Schumann, who lived from 1810 to 1856, and it was his Opus 48, number 7. And of course, Schumann was one of the greatest Romantic era composers, Romantic era German composers of the 19th century. And he wrote a lot of lovely songs in his 46 years, as well as, you know, piano pieces and symphonies. And so I'm a big fan of Schumann's. And one of his works, Opus 48, was called, and please forgive my German because I never took German. I'm going to do my best to pronounce it. Dieterliebe. I believe that's how it's pronounced. And that was one of his song cycles that he wrote, featuring the poetry of Heinrich Heine. I'm not sure exactly how he pronounced that, who lived from 1797 to 1856. And it's a song cycle all about love. The narrator is singing about his love for this particular woman, and all of the songs in the cycle are about that and just different themes on that. So this particular song in the cycle is actually more of a cynical piece because it's called Ich grolle nicht, which translates to I bear no grudge, or I've seen various translations. Some say I will not grieve, but it looks like the most literal translation is I bear no grudge. And he's singing about his love for this woman who he believes has scorned him, but he still loves her anyway, and he just can't help himself. And so it's really a powerful song, and I just enjoy singing it. So so I hope you'll enjoy it as well. So from circa the 1840s, early 1850s, unless I find out the exact year, the piece is Ich grolle nicht. Ich rolle nicht, und wenn das Herz auch bricht, ewig verlorenes Lieb, ewig verlorenes Lieb, ich rolle nicht, ich rolle nicht, wie du auch strahlst in Diamantenpracht, es fällt kein Strahl in deines Herzens Nacht, das weiß ich längst. Ich rolle nicht, und wenn das Herz auch bricht, ich sah dich ja im Trauma, und sah die Nacht in deines Herz ins Drama, und sah die Schlange, die dir am Herz entfrisst. Ich sah mein Lieb, wie sehr du elend bist. Ich rolle nicht, ich rolle nicht. This next song we're going to do is another song from musical theater, like many of the songs in this program are. Not all of them, but certainly a fair number of the pieces in this program are from musical theater. And this next piece is from the 1964 musical. I think it was 1964, but, you know, don't quote me on that for sure. Man of La Mancha. And I do know for sure, however, that it premiered at the Goodspeed Opera House in East Haddam, Connecticut. And it is always been a show that, well, I can't say that it's been a show that I've loved because I've never actually seen it, but I do like the music from it a lot. And I've always wanted to see an actual stage production of the show, particularly because I've always loved this next song so much, and particularly the version by the great Robert Goulet, for whom I would argue it was one of his signature songs. But other artists, including the equally great Andy Williams, have sung it, have covered it, used to sing it as well. So I hope you'll enjoy my rendition of this next song, which has been often covered over the last, you know, 50 plus years at this point. And the reason it fits into this program, I think, is because it's sung by, you know, Don Quixote, the protagonist of the show, and his quest is, you know, one of his star-crossed love for this peasant girl, Dulcinea, and he, no matter how delusional some people may think he is in his quest, he still persists and still believes that no matter what, that no matter how hopeless, no matter how far, he'll somehow achieve his goals and his dreams. And so it's one of the more inspirational pieces in the show, and perhaps some would say cynical in that they might say he was delusional, but nevertheless, I think it's quite an inspirational song, and I hope you agree. So from Man of La Mancha, with words and music by Mitch Lee and Joe Darien, the song is called The Impossible Dream, or The Quest.
Chase from afar, to try when your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. And the world will be better for this, that one man scorned and covered with scars still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable star. This
next song we're going to do is another piece from musical theater, and another relatively modern one, at least if you consider 40 years relatively modern. It's hard to believe it's that old, frankly, but 1981 was indeed 40 years ago. And the show from which this next song comes is Andrew Lloyd Webber's Cats. And of course, Cats is one of the longest running Broadway musicals of the last, you know, century, really. And of all time, probably one of the longest running ones, surpassed by only a few other shows, including Andrew Lloyd Webber's other show, The Phantom of the Opera. But perhaps the most arguably, I'd say, the most famous song he ever wrote is probably this next song from Cats, and was based on the poetry of T.S. Eliot with lyrics adapted by Trevor Nunn. So with music by Andrew Lloyd Webber, I think this song speaks really to the whole theme of our program of wistfulness and love and recalling bygone days of love and of just happy times and the memories associated with that. And so fittingly, this next song from Cats is called Memory.
Midnight, not a sound from the pavement. Has the moon lost her memory? She is smiling alone. In the lamplight, the withered leaves collect at my feet, and the wind begins to moan. Memory, all alone in the moonlight, I can smile at the old days. I was beautiful then. I remember the time I knew what happiness was. Let the memory live again. Every street lamp seems to beat a fatalistic warning. Someone mutters, and a street lamp gutters, and soon it will be morning. Daylight, I must wait for the sunrise. I must think of a new life, and I mustn't give in. When the dawn comes, tonight will be a memory too, and a new day will begin. Another night is over, another day is dawning. Touch me, it's so easy to leave me all alone with the memory of my days in the sun. If you touch me, you'll understand what happiness is. Look, a new day has begun.
Well, this next song that we're going to do is one of my personal favorites, and I know I can be accused of saying I have a lot of favorites. It's true, but this one has been a favorite of mine really for many, many years, and since I was a kid. And believe it or not, it was actually Leonard Nimoy whose version of this song I first heard. Leonard Nimoy, as in Mr. Spock, or not Mr. Spock, whatever his title was. Officer Spock's on Star Trek. And he had a few albums that he came out with, excuse me, in the 1960s of singing. And his debut album was called Mr. Spock's Music from Outer Space. And this was one of the songs on the album. And so long before I had ever heard the Broadway show from which it originally came, actually, I should say the West End show from which it originally came, I associated it with Leonard Nimoy. But I later came to find out, when I became more musically literate and, you know, musical theater literate, that this song was written for the 1960 West End musical Oliver, based on Charles Dickens' book Oliver Twist, featuring words and music by Lionel Bart. And it became a sensational smash hit in England on the West End. And it later, in 1960, and it later transferred to Broadway in January 1963, so about 58 years ago this month, as of the time of this recording, which is January 2021. And it features so many wonderful songs in the score. I love the whole show. I actually got to see it when I was in England with my parents a long time ago when I was like, I don't even remember how old I was, but I was in I was in school, and it was about 10 years ago. And we saw a West End revival of this show of Oliver, and it was great seeing it in the place where it originally debuted and premiered. So from Oliver came a lot of beautiful songs, but this one's perhaps the most beautiful from the score. Oliver sings it when he's just gotten out of the orphanage, and he's been more or less adopted, basically just as an indentured servant by an undertaker. And he is basically forced into servitude to work for this undertaker for briefly before he meets the Artful Dodger and Fagin and all of that. He's working for this undertaker, and he's sitting in the basement of this undertaker's house near coffins, and it's really quite morose. And Oliver is just sitting there and starts singing this plaintive song, asking where is love, and wondering if anyone will ever love him, because he's been an orphan all of these years and without any family that he knows about. And it's just such a beautiful and wistful song that just goes to show that not all love is romantic love, and that the love of having a mother and or a father or parents and family is just as important as any kind of romantic love, and really just having any sort of human connection is the most important kind of love that everybody needs. So from 1960s Oliver, this song is called Where Is Love?
Skies above, is it underneath the willow tree that I've been dreaming of? Where is she? Who I close my eyes to see? Meant for only me. Who can say where she may hide? Must I travel far and wide till I am beside the someone who where is love? When I see the face of someone who I can mean something to,
this next song we're going to do is really the song that inspired me to put this program together, and it's really the song that inspired the theme, the sort of the wistful theme of love songs that have a certain nostalgic and wistful, sometimes plaintive quality to them. And this is one of the most beautiful songs of the Great American Songbook, in my humble opinion. It's certainly been covered by many, many artists over the years, and it actually served as Liberace's theme song on his television show, and he recorded it many times over the years and always performed it in his Las Vegas acts and his other cabaret and, you know, big shows that he would do. So I always associate it with Liberace, but, you know, Frank Sinatra, Bing Crosby, everybody has covered this song at one time or another, it seems. But not everybody always does the intro. Liberace did do the intro at least once, but I think the intro adds a little bit of extra context to it, the verse, that isn't always performed. And so I hope you'll enjoy the song in its entirety. It was written back in 1938. With music by Sammy Fain and words by Irving Cahal. And if Sammy Fain's name isn't familiar to you, it really should be, because he wrote so many wonderful songs of the 20th century, many of which were nominated for Academy Awards for movies or won. For instance, Love is a Many Splendored Thing, and that was an Academy Award winner, and April Love was nominated. Many other hit songs he wrote as well, including Dear Hearts and Gentle People, and even as late as the as 1977, he was nominated for an Academy Award for a piece called Someone's Waiting for You, for the Disney film The Rescuers. So he had a very long career, even though his name isn't as widely known as someone like, say, Cole Porter or Irving Berlin or Jerome Kern. But he's nevertheless equally important, in my opinion, and if for no other reason than for this next song. So I hope you'll enjoy it. It's called I'll Be Seeing You.
Cathedral bells were tolling, and our hearts sang on. Was it the spell of Paris or the April dawn? Who knows if we shall meet again? But when the morning chimes ring sweet again, I'll be seeing you in all the old familiar places that this heart of mine embraces all day through. The park across the way, the children's carousel, the chestnut trees, the wishing well. I'll be seeing you in every lovely summer's day, in everything that's light and gay. I'll always think of you that way. I'll find you in the morning sun, and when the night is new, I'll be looking at the moon, but I'll be seeing you.
Well, before we do this last song, I would like to first thank everybody who's watching right now. And I don't actually know who's going to be watching right now, but I hope that many of you, I hope a lot of people, I should say, will have a chance to see this, because we haven't gotten to perform in person for a lot of audiences, really any audiences, for a very long time at this point. And so I hope that you've enjoyed this program. And if you're watching it, I hope that we'll have the chance to perform for you in person again soon, that we have the chance to do another program for you again soon, either via DVD or video or live stream or in person or whatever. And I just hope we have the chance to do it again soon. And I hope you've enjoyed this program. And I'd like to extend a big thanks to our pianist over here who... Let's see. Let's make sure she can be seen.
Oh, no.
Gail Hyde over at the piano. So thank you, Gail. And we're very professional over here. We don't have a player piano going in the background. So so thank you, Gail. And we're going to conclude our program today with a piece from 1934, and it was written with words and music by the composer Ernest Charles. And Charles was an American composer who wrote a lot of songs that the tenor Robert White, who is still alive today, he's one of the most famed living tenors, who has made many prestigious recordings over the years. He did an album which included this song, and he's, I believe it was he who said that Ernest Charles' songs bridge the gap between the more highbrow, if you will, highfalutin art songs of the day, of the early to mid 20th century, and popular songs, like bridge the gap between Samuel Barber and Cole Porter, for instance. And I think that's a good way of putting it, because this is a song that I think is easily relatable. You know, it has a beautiful sentiment and beautiful music in its lyrics, beautiful sentiment. But it's also a great piece, a vocally demanding piece that I've heard a lot of famed tenors as well as famed sopranos sing over the years, including my personal favorite soprano, the great Miss Jeanette MacDonald, who sang this back in the early late 30s, early 40s, and I have her recording on 78. But so many people have covered this song over the years. In fact, if you've seen the movie, I can't remember what the title of it was. I think it was just Florence Foster Jenkins, but it was about the the wannabe opera star Florence Foster Jenkins, who had delusions of grandeur. She was a millionaire, so she could afford to rent out theaters to, you know, hire audience members to come watch her sing, because no one would otherwise come see her because she was so terrible. Meryl Streep and Hugh Grant made a movie a few years ago about her life, and actually Meryl Streep, who, believe it or not, actually has a very nice singing voice, sang the song in the end credits. So it's been covered by a lot of people over the years, and I think it provides a nice fitting conclusion to our program, because its lyrics say that once the narrator of the song has sung his songs to his beloved, he will sing no more, because he would rather never sing again than to share the memories associated with those songs and those dreams with anyone else. And I love that. I love that sentiment and that idea. And I hope you'll enjoy this song, When I Have Sung My Songs. Thank you, everybody, and thank you, Gail. I hope that you enjoyed this program, and I appreciate you all watching. And that's all. That's all for now, folks. So, if anybody's interested in CDs, we're gonna have a CD of this very program that's gonna be made as well, a compact disc and MP3 downloads. And I've got other CDs available. And so this one and all my others you can find on www.caseyjonescostello.com and on my Facebook page, facebook.com/caseyjonescostello. So I hope to see you all again and perform for all of you again soon. And I hope you're all doing well, whoever you are watching this right now. And thank you so much. And I hope you've enjoyed it. So goodbye.